We're here. It's what's 5 minutes since we started streaming? Remember the horrible suicide game that was? I don't play superhero games really all that much. But please tell me more about it. It's Wednesday. It's free for Prime right now. That's hilarious. That's hilarious. It is. What day is it? It's Wednesday. It's the middle of the day, which means it's time for us to do some Valhalla. I don't know how much longer the game is. I imagine we just go up to the new year. That would be my guess. But, let's play. I'm uncertain. It came out in March. Oh, damn. They're like, we want this shit out of our stores, please. How are you? I'm doing pretty good. I slept too long though. I did not get out of bed till like 12, 15, something like that. So I ate and then I immediately had to start streaming. No responsibilities were done today, which is probably why I'm doing so well right now. But we got Valhalla today. It's our last. I imagine this is gonna be left. Because, like, what are you gonna do after New Year's? Christmas just happened. I don't know. You know? Let's get to it. How are you guys on this beautiful Wednesday? Joe bought what she wanted. Rent is due on the 30th. If we don't. We have a save prior to today, and if we don't have enough money, we're gonna have to go back. I don't know. We might just have to get the bad end, I guess. Which would suck, because we've done what we could, you know? Good evening. Hey. Okay, so we've almost got everything, but we're still missing a couple of things for Saturday. And so I designated you, Gillian Applegate, as official guy who goes to buy the rest of the stuff. Applegate? Okay, a bit tired. Might take a nap. Naps are great. I love taking naps. I have no idea who that is. Why me? I could send Jill, but I don't want to dare send a lady by herself. And I could go with her, but I believe the bar should have at least two people in the vicinity at all times. You're not gonna say anything, Jill. If it means not being delivery girl, I'm happy to fake helplessness. Fine. Give me the list. I'll be back sometime. Something tells me you're planning something, boss. What gave you that impression? Call it a gut feeling. Did you know Gil has a crush? What? Mine of his, a girl that owns a bazaar. She's been coming to him for ages and he's only just started opening up. But he's taking steps backwards and I'm not gonna let him. He's opening up for fuck's sake. And so the errand will take him to the bazaar, I take it. That's right. Alright then, off to the office I go. As for me, it's time to play the game. Time to mix drinks and change lives. Gil with a crush, huh? This place, great! Oh, if it isn't... Hey, Jill, sorry, but is there anywhere I can hide? There is an unpleasant guy on my trail. Boss, stocked woman incoming. The door is open. Go ahead, the door on the left. Thanks. Hello there. Oh, hi there. The other one, that's the bathroom. Wait, what's the dog doing in the bathroom? Now, where did she... Oh, the hellhole, perfect. Hey kid, I'll have the usual. Right. You remember me after 2 weeks? Usual drink, that's a big beer. He wants a big one. All mixed. Bam. Get to it. That's not it. Okay, don't serve that then. Whew. I fucked up somehow. You think I did not put enough? Okay. Okay. Mix it. We did it. It took us twice to figure it out. Alright. Here. That seems right. The paper's been a mess lately. You'd think with all that's happening, they'd stay and do more reports. But they're all asking for vacations, and I can't afford to be understaffed. So I had to come up with some sort of reward for whoever produces the most reports. I see no difference in my feed, though. Mr. Donovan, I don't mean to sound rude, but you do know the infamy of the augmented eye with the general public, right? A shitty page that'll over-sensationalize anything and report useless things. Of course I know. Then why not try to rectify that image? To put it simply, I'm being clutched by the balls in a non-pleasant way. Zaibatsu Corps and Company have an eye on every publication they haven't bought yet. Report on them once and they'll find something to fine you with. Twice, and you'll find your resources severely cut. Anything beyond that, and the best case scenario is that they'll buy the damn operation to keep it quiet. I know there are more newsworthy things than whatever it is the lackeys picked out that week. But if I overstep, my ass is on the line. Glad to see this hellhole is still in one piece. The BT... I almost saw that said bitch. I'm like, damn, okay. The BTC has been going apeshit closing bars lately. Oh, yeah, that. Yesterday, they closed one that served as a key part of a drug trafficking ring. And last week, they closed three small bars that served as illegal chicken restaurants. Not to mention there are like 100 people who have BTC certificates but never use them. Instead, they keep those credentials around to stop police from raiding their homes and warehouses. I don't know about you, but it's obvious to me that some restructuring will begin at the BTC after this whole thing. Man, shit ran deeper than I thought. And no news outlet talks about that. Alright kid, let's try a moonblast now. Come again? Hey, even I have to break the routine from time to time. Moonblast. That's interesting. Not the Mars blast. Moonblast. Thank you. 6, Charlie Delta. And 2 Gamma Drain. Which means we're making it big! Hold on. Okay, that's 6. I can't count. Please don't make me. On the rocks and blended. Yum 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 yum. I sure hope that was okay. Now, let's see what the ruckus is about. What brought you here? Alright. Did you see a Lilum coming here? Blue hair, big tits. She's the one from the Encore concert coming up. Not really. Did she jump to the roof? Why were you looking for her? Did you want an interview? Not really. Just hitting on her. Hey, I said hitting on her, not hitting her. Stop glaring. Why, though? Are you that bored? Don't you have, like, a family or something? Have you seen that girl? Hot as tits. Also, hot ass and tits. I'm suffering the weirdest combo of being hard as fuck and curious as shit right now. I want to know just how detailed those king-class Chiyo models are personally. Yeah, I'm sure. And so you followed her. I've yet to meet a woman that can resist the charms of Donovan D. Dawson. You're in front of one, and I'm guessing you have quite the selective memory. Like I said, don't you have a family or something? A wife, but that woman cheats on me as much as I cheat on her. In fact, I'm pretty convinced she gets off on the thought of me cheating on her. So that Lilim isn't here, huh? I'll have to find a busty enough replacement tonight or I'll explode. Hey, after you're done glaring, please serve me a pile driver. Right. Just give him a pile. Literally. This guy is pretty scummy. One, two, three. Okay. All mixed. Mix that shit. Pile drive. Here. Alright. Well, seeing as she's not here, I have no reason to stay. Maybe I'll find someone that looks a bit like her. I left! Oh. Alright. Thanks for sheltering me, Dana. I hope your sister likes the video. No, thank you! Seems you had a hearty talk. Your boss is such a fun person. Her sister is a fan of mine, so I recorded a small video for her and took a couple of photos. How nice of you. It's nothing, really, and she did hide me, so it's the least I could do. But, well, we're here already. Mind giving me something sweet? Sure. Miss Ida wants something sweet. Let's look at the sweet drinks. It's not expensive enough. Blueberry, 170, but berry is more expensive. 180. 180, the moonglass is more expensive. 250! Piano woman. 320! Alright, let's do that one. It's so expensive because it's a big drink, okay? Alright, let's get to it. 1, 2, 3. Aged. 5, 2, 3. Okay. Piano woman. Here. Thanks. So, do you know why Donovan was following you? I don't, but I wasn't in the mood to deal with him. His questions were a bit over the line last time, too. Not the worst I've dealt with, but I just don't want to humor him. I see. Seems like he was just trying to come on to you. You don't say. Well, not like he'd have a chance anyway. I'm not into older guys, and I'm already committed to a relationship. Wait, you are? It's not common knowledge, and the ones that hear it try to dismiss it as rumors, but now I've been in a relationship with my producer for a while now. Really? This is tea. We were both single, and that kind of stuff is bound to happen when you spend so much time together. But it all started when he read an entry I made in my blog about wanting to experience love and the like. He offered to help with that after he read it, and I thought, sure, why not? I really knew him well enough, and it wouldn't hurt to try. How nice. He's a stick in the mud when planning is due, but he's a sweetheart otherwise. I see. You know, I've met two fans of yours lately. Really? Both of them seemed so excited when they were talking about you. It was amazing. I don't like the term fan too much. It strikes me as a bit pretentious, in my opinion. I have many fans doesn't sit so well. I like many people who like my music better. Fan evokes an uglier and more pretentious image of me. Do you like what I do, Joe? Do you like my music? To be honest, I haven't had much exposure to your work, but the few things I've heard are really good. And not gonna lie, having talked to you, I feel like I would support you even if I didn't like it. So nice to hear. Hey, this will sound familiar, but do you have anything like tea? I have like the Mulan tea. Yeah, I have like a Mulan tea. Yeah! Spice tea! And that's $500. That's gonna be great for me. Here. Perfect. Hey, you're a King Class Chia, right? That I am. May I ask you something about your model? Sure. Are there any differences between you and a DFC-72? We both serve the same purpose, but DFC-72s have the port on their heads, which makes them more versatile. My line lacks that, or the resilience of the DT-01Ds, but we're a tad more polished elsewhere. More specifically, our voice emulators are more enhanced, and our movements are smoother. A trade-off of functionality and power for appearance, you could say. I see. So, anything new for this concert? Well, it is an encore, so we're trying to make it the same for those who couldn't go to the first one. But we always try to spice it up, like maybe with a surprise song or something. There was this one time I sang a cover of a song by B. Link. Of course, in return, they sang Your Love is a Drug. Ah, so you know the B. Link girls. Really nice kids. You'd be surprised how different from their onstage personas they are. Really? Suzu, for example, can be rather childish at times. She also laughs a lot, and loudly at that. Meanwhile, Aina is a party girl through and through. If they're not on tour, she spends her time partying like crazy. Hard to believe. I mean, their image is that of stoic girls with little expression. Almost like living Victorian dolls or something? Well, they wanted to pop out in the public. Eh. They once told me, if we want people to notice us, we have to break the cutesy idol concept. And so they took the opposite route to becoming cool beauties with... Oh wait! That's me! They took the opposite route by becoming cool beauties with melancholic songs. I wouldn't say they went the opposite way. The opposite of cutesy idols would be unkempt, tone-deaf girls spewing vitriol and hate. True, I guess. Well, I've gotta go, but let's have a sparkle star first. Alright, sparkle star. Bam, bam, bam. We're making it a big drink. One, two, bam. Anyway, aged and mixed. Here. Sparkling. Well, it's always a pleasure to. Please come again. Will do. Oh, the handsome bartender. Nice to see you. Boss, Gil's back. I'll take my break. Alright. Break came real fast. Save. It's our last... Wait. What? When is... We're doing it on the 17th. On the 17th. That's hilarious. Also, what day is it in the game? Because I feel like, isn't New Year tomorrow? I don't remember at all. I am all over the place. Note to self, buy oil for that door. Let's get going. Alright then. Gil, you're in my spot, please. No, sorry. Also, you're cleaning one of the boss's chicken buckets. Did boss ask you to do that? If I told you she did, would you believe me? Without a doubt. Let's go with that, then. Right. Greetings. Stella, what can I get you? I'll go with the Bleeding Jane today. Simple enough. Leading Jane. Bronson. Cartagolta. Fushi. Do it again. Put it in. Do not age that shit. Blend it. Yeah, baby! Bleeding drain! Send it. I always get nervous right before I send it. Thank you. What brought you here today? Waiting for Sai? Or Sai? I came by myself, actually. I was in the area and stopped by to say hi. It's pretty interesting, though. When I first saw you, I doubted you'd ever come here again. Well, this place is comfortable, I must admit. So quiet and secluded. It's oh so clean, really clean. Gil's the one you can owe that to. The guy takes pride in how clean he keeps things around here. If you ever need cleaning stuff, he's a nice pick. Really? Mm-hmm. He's a bit out of it today, though. I see. Hey, Jill, have you heard of a new gold rush in the city? Gold rush? Everyone is paying small fortunes to get their hands on pieces of white knight suit, suits. I think I heard or read something about that, but I'm having my doubts, so probably not. In any case, how is it a gold rush? Well, the tech behind the suits was always safely guarded, but after the events at the bank... After the events at the bank, the suits were remotely shut down, bricking many of them in the process. Many units dropped their armor right there and fled when the lynchings went on. Any white knights still stuck in their suit had to take their armor off manually to run away. It all happened in the middle of the lynchings, so they'd be sitting ducks if they didn't. Some weren't that lucky. They got beaten up while they weren't able to move. So between the suits becoming glorified paperweights and the many white knights going on the run, there ended up being a lot of junk lying around. But the whole scientific community is rejoicing. They're on a race to reverse engineer the suits and take as much technology as possible from them. And of course, even single pieces of armor fetch a high price these days. Could anyone see any profit from that research to justify those expensive words? It's new tech, a whole new field ripe with patents just opened for many. So I'd say yes. Huh. I mean, the BTC is literally a conglomerate built upon patents and trademarks. I can see how. There is one weird case, though. There's this guy named Jack. He's the captain of a very unique Blitzkrieg core unit. Unique? The guy had a really small unit, 5 people including himself. The aesthetics of his unit armor were heavily modded to the point that they looked like a squad of Henshin heroes. Henwa? They looked really gaudy. But it turned out that the guy actually broke through the software and disabled the remote switch. He has one of the few, if not the only, suits of armor with the OS intact. To say they're among the most wanted people would be an understatement. I think that was a spelling mistake. You know a lot about this. It's interesting the amount of things you hear when dealing with drunk people of all kinds in the same place. It also helps to put on a front that makes people lower their guard. That would sound familiar to you. True. Wait. Here's a freebie. A fun fact. The failsafe was originally going to involve the armor blowing up and leaving no traces. But regulations and laws didn't allow that kind of technology near civilians. I guess even Zaibatsu Corps has its limits, huh? People love to demonize Zaibatsu Corps because, let's face it, they're far from innocent. But they're not evil overlords, they're just greedy. They're just a big corporation. They just so happen to have control over what tantamounts to a city-state. But corporations will naturally resort to draconian methods. I've heard horror stories from people outside the city about trying to use product placements. If you so much as hold a bottle the wrong way or get in the way of a logo, you'll be in for lots of trouble. And let's not start the theme parks or the like. Those are dystopias of their own. Then again, most of the demonization is due to Quincy being such a clown. He has no power anyway. He's just the front that whatever council behind Zaibatsu Corps chose. He makes a fool of himself and the attention is taken away from whatever it is that Zaibatsu Corps is actually doing. So, what you were saying is that Glitch City is basically a huge theme park? I've called the White Knights glorified mall security in the past, so, yeah. No, seriously, and what? Can I get a Brantini here? Sure. Let's give her a Brantini. Brantini. So, why is my thing so freaking... My sensitivity is all out of whack. And then a karma dream. Aged mixed. Brantini. Oh, Stella's such a good tipper. I love Stella. Thanks. So I take it you're in a good mood today. Does it show? A bit. Yeah, well, I managed to nab a couple of trinkets for the Q and Mickey Encore concert. Nice. Oh, right. As it turns out, she was just here. Again? Sorry. Again? Can't believe I just missed her. I was surprised, too. I was more surprised she remembered my name, though. And, like last time, she was quite the graceful client. Man, so those rumors about her being really nice in person were actually true? Amazing. I mean, you always want the famous people to be nice in real life. But having such backing to that claim, to hear that she's so nice to everyone, it's nice to hear, you know? In fact, many think that what's made her so famous so quickly, how she's down to earth and totally accessible, making her someone everyone wants to root for. Ah, I see. Yeah, I mean, I guess you don't want to feel like you're supporting crappy people. Although, to be honest, I've never put much thought into that one. Hell, half the time I have no idea who made what I use, nor do I care much. Being a nice person will take you far, though. My daddy always insisted that being ruthless in the boardroom doesn't mean being an ass. And he's actually managed to get certain contracts over other more powerful people. All thanks to being a nice guy overall. Seems like good advice. But more importantly, Daddy? Do you really believe me saying she was just here that easily? You're not the kind to lie about stuff like that, so sure. Thanks, I guess. That said, can you go to the concert that easily? What about security and the like? My dad always has a unit keeping an eye on me from a distance. And you'd be surprised at how easily I can disguise myself with just a different hairdo and a cap. Hairdo. Oh, like... I thought she was talking about, like, changing her hair entirely. I'm like, you wanna go blonde for the Kira Mickey concert? Go ahead, I guess. She meant, like, putting it in a bun or something. I'm stupid. I'm goofy. I see. I wonder if I could get in the disabled line with Say in her wounds. Although she'd probably nag me at how she doesn't need it and we shouldn't abuse it. Hey, can you get me a classic drink? Sure, a classic drink. Do we have coffee water? I wanna. Hold on. Hmm. Let's look at our most expensive classic drink. I think they're all gonna be 200. Classic, frothy water. Let's get this girl a big beer! Big girls need big beers. I need money so bad. Stop trying to age it! Oh, next. Beer. We did it. Here. Thank you. Do you have many servants around the house, Stella? I do, but they've been with us for so long, they're pretty much family. My dad always said that if you earn someone's trust, they'll gleefully work for you, and everyone wins. We even had a young gardener that left to study engineering, and he actually came back. He still comes by every weekend to tend the plants. Man, that sounds nice. Let me know if you ever need of a job, and I might find you something. Thanks for the offer. Wait. I just realized something's off with the whole tech gold rush story. What would it be? Wouldn't all the tech be patented anyway? I get trying to crack it in the first place, but... That would be true if the tech was patented in the first place. It isn't? Zaibatsu has been so paranoid about making the White Knights untouchable that they never patented anything. A patent would be in a database that someone could hack and retrieve valuable info from. Not to mention they've been using tech from other companies without any authorization. A hot girl I don't know have to talk to Dimbard. Hi. She is rather pretty, isn't she? I do like her. Me and the homies, we love Stella. She's a great tipper too. That's what matters. Oh, so there's a cat girl too. Hi Dimbard, welcome in. And no patent registry in their right mind would approve of that global shutdown signal. Let alone how it immobilized everyone still inside one of those suits. Quack. Hi, thank you for the quack. So the ones that were upholding the law did so using suits that are all, by all means, illegal? The irony runs deep, wouldn't you say? Why do it, though? When you have so much money, you start thinking you can screw around with the rules. All that power makes you think you're above every law there is. And the city is what happens when those with money start making the rules. Okay, back to work. Enjoy your cat girl and cat girl things. Thank you, Dimbard. I hope work goes well. I'm curious, though. Have you ever covered any fuck-ups by using money? I think we've all done things we're not proud of at some point in our lives. Well, Jill, I gotta go. Always a pleasure. Please come back. I mean, come again. Ah, Alma. No, hello? You're pretty insistent on that one, aren't you? It's basic courtesy. Something I will fight to uphold. First, the greeting stop. Then saying please and thank you stop. And before you know it, boom. Total anarchy. You're exaggerating. Am not. In fact, I'll go through the door again and I expect you to properly greet me this time. Fine. They're besties, Your Honor. They might be a little more than besties, who knows? Hello, Jill. Once upon a midnight dreary, while I pondered, weak and weary, over many a quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore, while I nodded, nearly napping, suddenly there came... The fact that she knows so much of this poem is ridiculous. As of someone gently rapping on my chamber door. "'Tis some visitor," I muttered, tapping at my chamber door. Only this and nothing more. You overdid it. You totally overdid it. Quoth the bartender, I did not. So you like poetry? I had a phase. Can I get you something? Let's start with a big cobalt velvet. You want a big one? Fuck yeah! Cobalt velvet. I got you too. On the rocks, next. Here. Thanks. Oh, yeah, there's something I've been wondering about for a while. Does the name Shadowmaster 69's Chronicles ring any bell? Excuse me. Wow, you went pale. No, the name doesn't ring any bells. May 22nd. Today my daily card readings told me that I'd meet great change thanks to an old man. My biology teacher told me I had been picked for an inter-school contest with my latest essay. I just knew a scientific theory on the idea of auras was as revolutionary as I thought. Soon I'll bring the world into the occult science rate singularity. Later entries don't seem to have gone that well, though. Mentions of being laughed at, being lectured on why the essay was wrong. Jill? I made sure to delete that blog. No evidence should be left. I can think of at least 6 different sources off the top of my head that all have that stuff archived. Hey, why? Sheesh, relax. It's not that bad. What do you mean it's not that bad? Don't you realize how embarrassing it all is? We've all been young, Jill. Relax. It's not like you're still like that nowadays. That would have been embarrassing. You're not still like that, right? God, no. I gave up on the whole occult stuff. It's just that remembering all that stuff is... I don't know. I like the way you looked. I'm dressed in black with the rare accessory popping out thanks to the colors. I mean, at least you had the decency to use makeup and take care of yourself. So you have a pick. Oh god, you have a fucking pick. Why do you do this to me? Why do you dig out the sins of my past? I was bored. Last Friday, I had to take my mind off the whole Diana thing, so I ran a small background check on you. Simple stuff, just checking past internet activity. Please don't run background checks like that. I just used a search engine, you know? I didn't request documents or anything. What led you to that page? You do realize your main mail account everywhere is still the one you used back then, right? Like I said, relax. You were obsessed with occultism and I wanted to kiss all the boys, and I kinda almost accomplished that in middle school, which still sort of haunts me today. Never underestimate the lengths old classmates will go to track you down. Especially if they think you're still the girl that kissed them for fun and they're lonely to boot. We all have things we're not too proud of as adults. Now I know how criminals feel when evidence is used against them. I have to ask, though, why the 69? It was supposed to be 69, not 69, like, in reference to both the lover and the hermit. I was convinced it meant wise choices. Chill, there's nobody that would read that as 69. I was 12 at the time. Even at 12, I fucking knew what 69 was. Just how innocent were you back then? You have no idea. Well, let's sweeten things up a bit. I'll have a sugar rush. Sure. Sugar rush. Optional karma. Hold on. Perfect. Optional! Hi, DJ. Welcome in. Almost. Okay.
How many times do we have to teach you this lesson, old man?
Hello, TJ. Thank you for the redeem. Sugar Rush. Perfect. We did it. Here. This is the thing.
I need a sensu for that one.
Thank you for the other, Radiant BJ. Say, Alma, speaking of the past, what was your last long-term relationship like? That's sudden. You dug through my past. I've earned the right to dig through yours. Fine, fine. Long-lasting relationships, huh? Romantic ones, I'm guessing? Yep. Well, I've had about 4 boyfriends who I describe as such that I've introduced to my family and all. The first one was in high school. I broke up with him because he cheated on me. I remember the other girl trying to pick a fight and me just saying, keep the fucker. The second one was during my freshman year. I broke up with him after he thought it'd be funny to punch me in the arm. He starts with a friendly hit and before you know it. Anyway, the other guy I met shortly after I dropped out. He was interested in marriage, but he wanted to get married only after only half a year or so of knowing him. And then there's Richard. Who? I spent almost 4 years with him. We got along pretty well. We had awesome chemistry. I truly loved him. But as time went by, there was a rift that started separating us. He just didn't like my family. He didn't? Moreover, he wasn't a family person. He distanced himself from his own and voiced that he didn't want kids. There was a part of me that wanted to believe, even if just for a little bit, that maybe he'd change his mind. But as much as I loved him, that one detail brought a growing gap between us. And at one point, I just had to break up with him. But I'm not here to depress you. Bring me a beer, will ya? Sure. A beer. I'll make it big. I can't. Sorry. Mixed. Thanks for telling me that, by the way. Don't mention it. Okay, one more question and we're even. Wow, you really are embarrassed of that blog, huh? Sure, ask away. At what age did you get those implants in your boobs? Chill. I love you, and I know you're saying that in jest, but I've lived through so many rumors about me getting plastic surgery that I can't and won't take it as a joke. As such, in honoring our friendship, I'll just say this. They're real, and they're spectacular. Now, ask the real question before I slap you. They're real, and they're spectacular. God bless. I'll grant you one, and only one chance to call me by my full name as compensation, then. Gladly take your offer. It's funny that you mentioned slapping because my real question was, why did you get your hands chopped? Chopped. Well, there's a couple of reasons. The first is that I spent lots of time typing and these replacements helped me avoid carpal tunnel syndrome, which is valid. There's other utilities like how I can interface with many devices. For example, there's a tiny computer embedded in my glasses. If I move my index finger, it acts like the computer's cursor. There's lots more, but they're small things that don't sound that impressive when I say it out loud. How did your family take the operation? They took it well enough, except for my mom. She freaked out for months. She even went to the hospital to ask for my hands. Don't you miss them? Sometimes, but just during emotional moments. But as luck would have it, someone else has them. Shortly before my operation, there was an accident on the highway. One of the victims was this young lady whose right hand got completely crushed. I told them to check if they were compatible and all that. I mean, implants are not everyone's first choice when they can get a natural replacement. A bit of cosmetic treatment and it could pass as her original hand with no problem. Last I heard, we were compatible and the family agreed to the donation. I don't know what became of her, but I hope she's fine.
And you didn't tell your mom about that?
I didn't want her pestering the poor girl. So, are we cool now? Are we even now?
Are we? You're pretty pissed about that comment regarding your boobs.
Again, I'm sorry, it sounded a lot less rude in my head. Yeah, don't worry about that. Besides, I get to call you Julianne once.
Now you don't.
Huh? Why? You just called me by my full name. Are you serious?
One chance and only one chance, and you just used it up.
Damn it. Surprise! Oh, it's Anna. Hey, Alma, this might be a weird tangent, but do you believe in ghosts?
Hey.
Not particularly, no. Although, there's this paper I read once that was quite interesting. It proposed a scenario where nanomachine clusters would leave the body after death, and then acted as a collective hive mind through residual brainwaves. The result would basically be an image not unlike a hologram. Of course, the hypothesis fell through because such nanomachine density is impossible in a body. Even 5% of the amount needed is enough to make the blood too dense for the heart. And it's not like the brainwaves are potent enough to create those reactions. Still, an interesting read, though.
I see.
Don't give me that look. It's not my fault that you convinced yourself you're crazy. Well, I'll leave then. See you tomorrow.
See ya.
Well done?
I am. What about you, Gil?
For some reason, the idol girl left him like that, it seems.
You think?
Might have been while he was out.
True.
Hey, boss, you're a big fan of wrestling, aren't you? I mean, you were a wrestler, so...
That I am, yeah. Why?
I was wondering, isn't wrestling fake?
Aren't twin tails for little girls and teens with 8th grade syndrome?
8th grade what?
When you get down to it, wrestling is as real as a soap opera.
I mean, you don't really expect a legal lawsuit to be fixed in a ring, right?
Sure, in my ideal world, you would solve legal problems through good old wrestling, but...
No, seriously, 8th grade what?
But you don't go around calling soap operas fake. It's a show, It just so happens to use fights as an expression. You might as well see it as a unique form of theater. Besides, considering the injuries many wrestlers suffer, it's not all fake.
I didn't think about it that way.
Sadly, I won't stand for anyone bad-mouthing wrestling. So now I have to go and break Gil's back to make you humble.
Oh, well, wait, what?
Come here, fuckboy!
8th grade what?
Who would have thought we'd get a bona fide idol in the bar?
Oh my god, we managed to pay our bills. We have $200 in our bank account. Oh my god. Oh my god.
That was great. That was scary. I was genuinely scared about making rent. Alright, Grand Slam Fighter Rent. A new heavyweight champion. Glitch City's most popular pro wrestling promotion crowned a new heavyweight champion yesterday, with Giant Yusuke taking the gold from fellow Japanese wrestler Justin Liger. As previous champion 6'6 American Kid was forced to relinquish the title due to a head injury, GSF decided to hold a tournament to find a new title award holder. The match ended after an epic 30-minute bout, with Giant Yusuke applying a massive German suplex for the 3 count. During an interview with AE, Giant Yusuke told us that through a translator that he's waiting for 6'6 American Kid to recover, Won't rest till I can beat him clean.
After the great earthquake, salvage agents of new age. The great earthquake that sank large portions of the world 5 years ago also created an unexpected new profession. Salvage agents. Summer Aki is one of those salvagers, and she shares her experience with the Augmented Eye. Seeing big cities like Tokyo and places like Caracas several kilometers below the ocean's surface, that's something that gets you, you know? Millions lived there before the great earthquake, and it's on me to retrieve their memories, their lives. Aki is now working to retrieve items from the research facility in the Tanegashima Island in Japan. New Lilim regulations. The current regulation preventing Lilim from looking too human have been working well so far, but Glitch City's government is planning to create even more new laws as to enforce robot-like features among the Lilim in a bid to reduce identity theft. Glitch City, the first nation to adapt to this current standard of artificial intelligence and robotics, was first to allow robots into normal society, quickly giving them necessary rights so as to sustain a long-term experiment about their role in human evolution. Unfortunately, the first year saw numerous reports of identity theft, resulting in the need for more stringent measures. It is unknown what kind of laws they'll have in the future regarding their existence. Ah, Kirimiki posted. Oh, she posted about us! The name sounds silly and a bit hard to pronounce. Good things, it's actually called Valhalla. The funny numbers and letters are just a code. Anyway, I visited this cute and small bar downtown twice after getting lost for a bit. I think the area was called Neon District. At first it was a bit scary because I forgot my way back, but once I got there, I felt really safe and at home. The bartenders are a bunch of sweethearts, and the boss was such a class act. I even took a photo with her and sent a video for her to her little sister. I look forward to visiting again. The drinks were very tasty, even though they weren't made of real alcohol. I don't know if I want the bar to suddenly become... Yeah. Thank you for all that content. I'm never gonna get the red nano camo. So sad. Anyway, save the game, and then we'll go to work. I don't think I can afford anything. I have absolutely no money. No money. Yeah, I got no money. Well, I guess it's time to go to work. Let's get to it. Friday, December 30th. So tomorrow's gonna be the New Year's. Okay. Unless there's 31 days in the month. I don't know how many days are in December. Gil, are you humming Shine Spark? Hey, Jill. Are you okay? Are you in love, maybe? Nothing of the sort. I'm fine. Right. No, seriously, did you fuck? Men only get so happy after they've fucked. That's not... Oh my god, you totally fucked. Was it Alma? Did you have 7 minutes in heaven with her? No, I didn't. In any case, congratulations! I haven't seen you this happy since... Well, never. Today's escapades will bring us to a familiar place and... Shit. Gil, I'm out. I'm gonna... Not so fast, flat bartender, if that's even your real name. There she is again! Stream Urchin! Last time, my viewership had a weird peak while I was passed out. So I'm here to find out what made people so interested.
Do I have something in my face?
This guy totally fucked. No doubt about it. That's the gleam in his eye. That gleam in his eyes is unmistakable.
Whatever, just keep it down.
Nah, Jill, you're here.
Isn't that the passed out girl from 2 weeks ago?
I'm not here.
Oh, sorry. I'll be back in my office then.
Anyway.
Just hanging out in the back or something? Like what?
Time to mix drinks and change lives.
Oh, these guys.
You are too happy and you are too mopey. What happened?
I was right.
Huh? That Laura girl was head over heels for him. I was right on the money.
Say, that girl.
I'm not here.
Sorry.
Isn't she the one that passed out last time? Anyways, Betty was right and that deserves a beer.
And you?
I'm fine.
Betty wants a beer. She's getting a big one in celebration. I don't need to make the drinks big anymore, but I'm still stressed, so I will be doing it.
Take it.
For the occasion.
Alright.
So the girl was actually infatuated with him? You should have seen her screaming from the top of her lungs that she liked him. And him just standing there thinking. Just like that. In retrospect, it was a tad too cliched for my taste. Ugh. Still, I knew she liked him. I was right. He doesn't seem particularly happy. He never is. Unlike your coworker. Holy shit, did he fuck?
You're making it too obvious, Gil.
How? That beaming face is unmistakable. The face of a guy that got some and enjoyed every moment. Back to the deal, though. Like I said, he seems lost in thought. Victories like these are few and far between. Let me enjoy myself. Can I get something non-alcoholic? That's not how you drown your sorrows, piece of scrap. I'll have a bloom light.
Okay.
A bloom light. I get that. On the rocks and mixed. Now we need unalcoholic. Which is not just here, is it? Well, let's look. Oh, it just doesn't need Karmatrine. Okay. Perfect. That's the first one. Literally the first one. Bloom light. But I almost forgot to change it over. Would have been embarrassing. All blended. Alright, serve that shit. Here. Yep. There. Thanks. Same. Celebrate all you want, but I'm freaking out over here. I know nothing about relationships. I have no idea what to do. Well, for starters, what do you think, Jim?
Me?
Her? Betty, I've seen a few of your relationships, remember? Aside from Veronica, there's Angela, Pamela, Sandra, Rita, Monica. Isn't that the people from Mambo Number 5? Erica, Tina, Mary, and Jessica. Or should I say, didn't share the bed sheets? Snores like a pig. Old feet, shampoo waster, chocolate addict. Too religious, fan of the wrong rugby team. teetotaler and chews with the mouth open. What do you think, Jill? That you must be quite the heartbreaker to have so many relationships in such a short period of time. I mean about piece of screen of situation. And thank you. I'm not the right person for this. Gil? He's still on fucking cloud nine. Or is it fucking in cloud nine? What about, sneaky sneaky? I'll be damned, she actually hides pretty well. For starters, how do you feel about her? I don't know. I don't know her that well. Where's my mouse? Okay, there it is. You could start there. Ask her out sometime, get to know her. Maybe she'll change her mind. Maybe you'll change yours. In the end, you lose nothing by... What? I'm just realizing I'm giving love advice to a Willem. So, I don't know how well it applies to you. These things are human and all, but organs nowadays. Even if that's the case, it's interesting that she felt that way towards him. Why wouldn't she? This fella's a good catch if I do say so myself. And, like I said, human and all, but organs. You surely encountered a Willem that you sometimes forget are not human. Well... We live in weird times, but hey, that only makes them more interesting. It's odd... Ooh, sorry. It's odd going to other cities and not seeing the same integration of Willem, though. Well, Glitch City is pretty much the cradle of societal experiments and involving Willem integration, so... Anyway... Just try to get to know her. You'll find out if you how you feel afterwards. Yeah, I think I'll try that. It's quite an uninspired advice, if you ask me. Anything else? Let's commemorate this occasion with a piano man and a piano woman. Oh, you get the piano man. Piano man. Piano man. Five, five, two, three, three. He uses less ingredients. Okay. Aged. Next. Piano woman, piano man. Sir, here. And now we reach a stalemate. I normally take the piano man, but I feel there's a symbolic value in taking the woman. My order like that then. Hate Laura. You what? Gonna take you away from me. My piece of scrap, not hers. You're mine. Mine! Betty, you don't own me. Besides, I can't, for the life of me, leave you alone. I feel like the moment I let you out of my sights, you'll just crash. It's not a laughing matter. You need someone making sure you aren't kicking people. That's not normal, you know? Besides, it's not like I have something with her yet. You're right. So you won't leave me? I'd worry myself sick if I left you to your own devices, honestly. We should leave now. Oh, yeah. We're holding a small New Year's party tomorrow. I don't know if you want to come. We'll come. Are you sure? We will. Fine. We'll be here, Jill. Anyway, see you then. Bye, Bill. Please come again. Party? I'd love to go. But I told everyone that tomorrow I'd end the year with a party myself, so... Sorry. I totally forgot she was already here. Man, that was such bliss. Still, I can see how traffic spiked. Things get fun here. And just like last time, I need to show my viewers something fun. Give me something nasty. Oh, she wants something nasty again. Oh, promo drinks usually suck. Sorry, I sneezed. And I refused to mute the mic before I sneezed. Like always. Grizzly temples are nasty. It's bland. Bitter. This one's kind of unbearable. That's hilarious. Blue lights. Bland. Spicy is gonna be enough. Sunstar. Sour. Bland. If you think something so balanced would actually taste nice, you'd be dead wrong. Four of each ingredients. Piano Man. Sour and strong. I should just be looking. If they all suck, I should just look for the most expensive one, which might be the Piano Man. It's a big drink. Piano Man or Piano Woman? Let's just. Oh, it uses less ingredients than the Piano Woman. Hold on. No, it uses the exact same. I'm stupid. I was like, oh wow, they just changed the amount of different drinks. Whatever. We're doing the Piano Man. It's on the rocks. See. Here. This is the. Hold on. It was nasty, alright. And now it's time for me to be a nice person and give you something nice. Huh? It's the second time I'm here, so it's only natural you get your own copy of my theme song. No, thank you. Don't be shy, let me give you one. I mean it, no thank you. Well, too late, it's already in your player. I can't. The ever living fuck did you do that? Magic. That's bullshit. Video editing magic. Did you just hack into the music player? Let's move on, shall we? Yeah, whatever. Hey, weren't there dogs? Last time you talked about this place like it was zany heaven of sorts. Zany heaven, haven of sorts, but I see the same shit. Seriously, no decorations or anything of the like? Good question. Where are the dogs? I either haven't paid enough attention to their arrival or they haven't come. Idols, newspaper managers, talking dogs, and yet this is the same old bar like last time. I might sue you for fake advertisement, you know? Now that I think about it, maybe Boss just donated money to the Hira thing. And then tricked the dogs into coming here as a part-timer for kicks. Ah, well, anything interesting lately? I mean, it's not like I miss them, but they should at least show their faces. Hello? Anime was a mistake, it's true. Sorry, what did you say? I was asking if there were any new stories. This is not a newspaper, you know. Nor is it a crazy stories on demand streaming service. A big fat lie, and you know it. Shut up. And I said nothing. So shut that idea up. Yeah, that. I won't. Last time I came here, the viewership peaked for some reason, and I want to find out why. Maybe Pretty Boy over there can tell us a story of who we fucked. He's so distracted he won't even make a retort. Amazing. I guess there's something worth saying, but And I want to hear it. Well, Kira Mickey came here, came yesterday again. You're shitting me.
W.
You expect me to believe that she came all the way here again? Do you even have proof like the glass from last time? Well, if I may interject. You've been listening, boss? The walls are pretty thin. Oh. Anyway, she did. I even took a pic with her. She did what? Let's see. Why? I try to make an appointment with her and she's always busy. But you sit there and she just comes waltzing over. It's not fair. Hey, if I knew how the hell stuff like this happened, I'd share my secrets. I was just as baffled as you are right now. Yeah, but I bet you're not even that much of a fan anyway, are you? You're not wrong. Can you at least tell me how nice she was as a client? Very graceful client, much like the last time. A really nice girl. I'm gonna give you my number. If she ever comes back, you let me know. You're not gonna let you keep her to yourself. I really doubt she'll come back again, though. She already came twice. I'm not taking any chance. Oh, wait, she already came twice. I'm not taking any chances. I need something to down this anger with. Give me something girly, will ya? A girly drink? Sugar Rush. 150. 170. Blue Fairy. Fluffy Dream. 50. 180. The most expensive drink we have. Splendid. Moonblast. Send that shit in. Here. Just as chill. Let's just chill for a bit. It's still not fair. You know, you're boring today. You're not chatting that much, nor are you doing anything funny. Maybe the whole peak viewership thing is just you. Eh? Maybe this bar and me both had nothing to do with the spike. Maybe you were just that good. Are you hitting on me? I'm not. In fact, I'm kind of trying to get you to leave, Bronto. Don't be so hard on the girl. She's fun. Another nuisance shows up. What? Joe hates me. It's not hate, it's just, wait, I'm not having this conversation again. Boring. Hey, you are curious, right? About Fuckboy's partner? Wanna know who it was? Do you know? Maybe not. That maybe not settles it then. Not taking any chances. Oh, come on. Bartender, you're making lots of faces there. It's nothing really. Did two bartenders break or something? Should I call the manager? Tech support? Hey, Joe, in and out her voices, remember? Fuck. What? Who fucked? Aside from that guy, I mean. Say, you're oddly calm today. Well, I've been getting more sleep lately. That way, I don't feel like if I stop speaking, I'll die. Crash is one hell of a drug. And wouldn't you know, I can actually make it premium time if I go commando. But come on, I'm getting bored out of my ass here. Do something. I'm not a dog. You can't just ask me to roll over, you know. Mind if I entertain you for a bit, then? Boss? You and Gil take a break. I'll entertain the missus here. The missy here. Alright.
Hey, Jill, by that I meant to take Gil with you. I don't want him humming to the middle of the road. To the middle of the road and right into a truck's grill. Grilled Gil. Right. Alright, Gil, come with me. Huh? We're having break time with Gil. Let's go! Maybe we'll get to know who he fucked. Want one? Thanks, I don't smoke. I got a text from Alma. Boss, Alma and Gil didn't fuck. Well, that's a bummer. She's sending congratulations your way, though. Tell her I said thanks, I guess. So, who's the lucky girl? So, it was a guy. I never thought you swung that way. It wasn't a guy. So, it was a girl, and you did fuck. I don't feel comfortable talking about that, you know? You don't make things easy for me, though. How so? I mean, you're pretty hard to get close to, you know? You never talk about yourself. You're talkative, so long as it doesn't involve you directly. Teasing you is literally the only way I know how to get through to you. You make me sound like some weird loner. You are a weird loner. At least tell me if you enjoyed the night you spent with whoever it was. I did. Good for you! Why are you humming Sunshine Stone so much, though? Well, after Idol Girl came yesterday again, I looked up her discography, and I can't stop humming or listening to them. Right. Oh god, you didn't fuck the Idol Girl, did you? No, why would that be a problem, though? I don't know. It just feels weird. Well, that's that for the break. Let's go back. Right. Oh, and Gil? Keep in mind what I said about opening up more. I mean it. That way we won't tease you so often. Listening to you say that has to be the weirdest thing I've heard this year. Shut up. I wonder if Alma finds Gil attractive. It's a good question. Hold on. Sorry. Go, streamer Chen. Yeah, baby! That's what we've been waiting for! I got an achievement for that. Put your playlist with a song you like. Okay, alright. And that's that. Back. What were you two doing back there? Fucking. Oh, so just chatting then. Holy crap, did you two really fuck? Sean has the face of a man who fucked to death recently. See, girl, Gil, you're making it too obvious. How? What will you have today? Have a gut punch. Coming right. Huh? What? Nothing. A gut punch. That is weird. I should not have chosen the streamer song. This is annoying. Hold on. Okay, perfect. Aged. Mixed. Got punch. Punch this. Here. Stop looking at me like that. Sorry. Are you okay? It's weird for you to order something like that. Yeah, I'm just trying out stuff. Did you know Lilim tongues are designed to identify food using chemical components? Our tongues were designed with the human ones in mind. For example, the first flavors that we detect are sour and bitter, just like you guys.
I checked my personal specs, and apparently my sensitivity is set to 1.2235 times. That makes me hate those flavors because I feel them harder. Why all that exposition? I mean, I'd lie if I say I wasn't interested, but why? Well, after last time, I got curious and started checking how many of my systems worked in detail. For example, the tips of my fingers are so sensitive to vibration, you could make a seismograph with them. Huh. And checking that, I found that it's all based on how humans work. And that got me thinking about what you said. I mean, for my system to work, humans have to understand how they work. And after all those discoveries, there's not any more or less artificial. Why should I be? I don't know. Looking up all of this, all of that suddenly made me feel real. It was the opposite of what I felt last time. I feel like I'm here right now. Glad to hear that. Alright then, let's try something sweet now. Yeah, something sweet. There we go. Look for the most expensive sweet drink we have. Oh, 170. Moon glass is 180. My tummy hurts. 250. I think that's her favorite drink anyway. Anyway, I thought I messed up the... Anyway. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 3. My tummy hurts, guys. I might not make it. I don't know if I can be brave about this tummy ache. Piano woman. My tummy hurts. Okay, back to it. Here. Nice. To be honest, it's a bit surreal for me. I'm here talking to you, and you're answering like any human would. You're even expressing happiness. I remember when I was a kid, I usually tried to strike conversation with AIs. But after a bit, they'd just start looping through their built-in answers, repeating the same thing over and over. That always made me crash back into reality. When I think back to that, having such advanced AIs like you here right now, it's amazing. I don't know. It makes my inner child happy to see something she always dreamt of. It helps me feel It helps when I feel particularly cynical. Aw, you flatter me. Besides, I always thought about humans like nature's Lilim. The method might have been different, but we too evolved from a more simple form ages ago. If Lilim managed to create biological life years from now, it will have come full circle. So, what should I take from this? What I should take from this is, you love me? Don't overdo it. Anything else? Let's go with the Shikaresh. Okay. By name, please. Optional Karmatron! Let's get her hammered! Get that shit in there. Here. Even in doubt, my love for these is real. How romantic. So I take the whole solipsist problem is solved? Yep. All the reality crises started the other day. My mom, guardian, call her mom, nobody's judging him. Mom decided to meet with the mother of her daughter's girlfriend. It was a very emotional meeting. They both said they felt like they closed a long chapter. I was moved, but that's when it set in. Why was I moved? I never met any of them, where do these feelings come from? Why do I feel things? Do I really feel them? What tells me someone else isn't pressing a button to make me feel that? What tells me I'm in my body? What is real? Boom! Welcome to being human, Torquay. Oh, don't worry, by the way. I'm fine. Thank God, it's unnatural to see you down like that. Man, this go-go is a blast. Don't you feel like talking a bit more with Dee Dee? Dee Dee is too much of a prick, and Go-Go is tired. Besides, I want to talk with the bartenders. Oh, fuck. Well, I tried. Jill, I'll be in my office. Cute little girl, Lilum. Cam girl. Oh, fiddlesticks. What's your name, girl? I'm Dorothy Hayes, at your service. Hold on. I'm gonna have to fix that later. You come here often? Are you hitting on me? Hey, Dorothy, I'm in the middle of a live stream. Do you want to participate? Sure, sounds fun. Okay, let's talk about recommendations from you. What should I drink next? Try the Sugar Rush. Bartender, a Sugar Rush over here. Bartender! Sorry, what? Sugar Rush, please. Right. Another Sugar Rush with optional Parmesan. Go, Broly, go. Sugar Rush. Yeah, it's right. Why am I double checking? It's right. Here. Good choice, Dorothy. Yay! So, what are you doing in my turf? Streaming Chan. Yes? No, I mean, that's what she calls herself. Man, that's a tacky name. Yeah, but it's my tacky name. Actually, that's not really my name. What's your real name, then? Behind Streaming Chan's awesome mask lies the humble Nicole Chen. Humble. Why not call yourself Streaming Chen? It's funny that you mention it. You see, when I started, I called myself Nico Nico Chen. I changed websites, so the name felt a bit out of place. Plus, I became Streaming Chen. Everyone nicknamed me Streamer Chan, though, so I just went along with it. Oh, yeah, I get it. At one point, I was going to call myself Dolores Hayes. But then I realized the name was as subtle as a brick to the face. Anyway, I'm here because the last time I came, I ended up with greater viewer numbers than usual. And so I wanted to treat my loyal audience again. Oh, I see. Well, you came to the right place, especially if you're looking for some comfy fun. Honey here might seem harsh, but you just need to crack her shell. Shut up. See, you just need to say the right thing at the right time and she becomes a sweetheart. Quiet, you. Don't play hard to get. You know it's true. Hey, stream girl. That's me. I'll regret asking this, but don't you have a sponsor? It's weird that it's been this long without some advertisement. I have, but you see, the contract with them expired, so Marvin, the business guy or whatever, had to make a new one. He was gonna send the draft to his lawyer, as it had a couple of additions, but let's say he got too excited with my VR model and the contract became unreadable. Oh, so he used the contract to... Yep, he got it into a new pair of panties and rubbed it vigorously on his penis. I mean, you'd expect certain principles to be upheld, even in the adult VR industry. I reported him and he got fired, but now they're looking for a new business person thing. Honestly, I think the paper cuts all over his dick are punishment enough. Detroit become human. Hi, Mercury. I mean, why the contract? I don't mind it if he jacked off to an image of me, but the contract? That's money that you're soiling right there. I would have gone back on the deal were it not for the owner paying me a visit and apologizing profusely. Some people, seriously. Oh, dick paper cuts. I've seen enough crazed teacher fantasies to know how they can be a problem. I don't think you need to have experience to understand that. That said, Gil's been grimacing for a full minute now. Don't mind me. Huh. But you know, I like you, Dorothy. Why don't we celebrate with beers? My treat. All right. Two big beers, honey. Hmm. Two big. They both want them big. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's just so deadly quiet in this bar. I'm feeling, I don't know. Mix that shit. Beer. Adding optional, okay. I will only add the required karma trap. Does that mean, well, I have to make a big beer. It's part of the thing. It's part of the order. But anytime it says optional karma trine, I will not do that for 5 minutes. I suppose I should get the timer out. 5 minutes. One powder delta, two powder delta. It is, why is it so quiet in this fucking bar? Mix. Beer. Beer. Serve. Here. Cheers. Cheers. Alright. I'm not feeling my tongue or my feet. Time to get lewd. Did I hear lewd? Do you have any stories? This will be a treat for non-premium users. I once met a guy that insisted on doing it in a jacuzzi. He didn't mind being in a premium time, so I started setting up the cameras. And man, was it a challenge. I wasn't just gonna stream over the water. I wanted some underwater action, too. What did you do with the bubbles and all? That was the least of the problems. We just turned off the jets. But not only did I have to make a makeshift underwater cover, I also had to keep in mind the heat. Heat isn't good with cameras. Did you try chilling the cam a bit and putting it in a bag with some filling? We made something more, convoluted. We took a small cooler, opened a hole for the lens, and sealed it with plastic. I made sure things looked good through the cam and started recording. Threw in some cooling packs and sealed the fuck out of the cooler. Did it need any weight? Yep, luckily the guy was into bodybuilding, so we used some old dumbbells. He was also ripped as fuck, but that's another story. It was all a success, but it's also the last time I had sex in a jacuzzi. Blood rushing, hot water, fuck, I was dying midway through. Thank God he decided to resume the action out of the water midway through, I would have surely died. At least the guy didn't burn himself. What do you mean? Last time I had sex on a jacuzzi, my body got so hot, the guy almost burned his dick. I considered investing in a cooling system, but it's so situationally expensive that I'll pass. Besides, those cooling systems require too much maintenance. Wait, I need to leave, but care to join me in escapades for the rest of the night? Can I plug my services in at the end of the night? Sure. Then count me in. I've got the perfect stories. Let's be on our way then. Goodbye, bartender. Bye, honey. Well, let's play the story. You see, there was this mega Santa. Wait, seriously? They left. A pair made in hell. At least they look like they're having fun. Feel this sudden urge to describe to streaming chat, I know. That method of filming underwater sounded convoluted as fuck, though. But I guess it's hard to keep a cool head when you're horny. We're done, boss. Man, don't you just feel great? Are we in the same place? Here, Jill. What's this? A bonus. Today I got a taste of the kind of clients you deal with, and keep it up. Well, tomorrow's a big day, so get ready. That goes for both of you. Either I'm getting old or that girl was too much even for me. 600. Nice. I have $2,000.
May all your wishes come true in a bountiful year filled with health and joy. Happy New Year. Yeah. Very nice. I forget I have to hold this. There's no new news? I'll leave the closet open in case you want to hide from the noise. Thanks. Guess who has Genshin reinstalled? Hi, Clown! Welcome! You have Genshin, huh? Who are you pulling for? Why? What inspired you to reinstall Genshin Impact? We can buy things now, though. Ow, my tummy hurt. We might have to go on break. The Kirara. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you were talking about Kirara. Duh. I'm really excited. I really like Kirara's outfit. It looks really cute. It's vintage gaming. Today's the last day, ain't it? So I don't really need to... I deserve these cartridges. There. $500. I can still buy something. How are you? I'm doing... My tummy hurts. I'm barely holding in there. Yeah, baby. We might have to go on break. So that I can go bathroom. Dismiss this message. Look, we got our clay houses. Oh, this place looks nice. Yeah, okay. We're gonna go on a break. This is the time to go bathroom, snack, drinks, do what you need to do, and we will be back shortly.
I think I feel a little better. I think I feel okay. But yeah. Tummy ache crisis averted. Let's continue with the game. We did everything. It's the last day, I think. So, make sure we save. Perfect. Now let's go. Tummy work. Saturday. It's the 31st. Bumble, this man's fake. He removed his smooch redeem. How am I supposed to smooch him now? Tummy. Ugh. Well, let's see. Gail's in the back getting everything ready. I'll go grab some food. I'll go grab some food I've ordered. They only agreed to work on New Year's if I went to pick it up myself. Are you alright? I'm scared. Gabby will show up any minute. Relax, everything will be alright. I can assure you of that. Drink something. Maybe that'll cheer you up. Maybe. I'll leave you for a bit, but keep your chin up. If you get through this, I'll give you a hug. Does that work? A hug? No, big one. For reward after everything's said and done. Gotta go. You can do it. Right. Everything's fine. You've been avoiding this for all these years. Now it's time to face it head on. Yeah, everything's fine. Everything will be better after I talk to Gabby. Boss might even give me a hug. I'm okay. Hello. Gabby. Come in. Excuse me. Welcome to Bell. Hey. You talk first. No, Well... Some days ago, I got a letter. And even odder than getting a letter is the fact that... it was from your sister. What? My sister sent you a letter? That's the first I've heard of it. What did it say? I don't know. I never opened it. At least, not until now. I figured I should read it with you. Yeah, let's do it. Let's read it. Alright then. Sorry. Just that? Yep. Isn't there anything else in the letter? Maybe on the back? This is just like your sister. I spent days worrying about this letter, not wanting to open it for fear of what it might contain. I lost sleep and appetite thinking about it. And after all those worries, after all those problems, after all these years of not talking to her, she sends me a letter, a fucking letter of all things, and she just says sorry. Sorry for what? For our fight? For not talking all these years? Ugh, now I'm fucking pissed. Are you laughing? Sorry, I just... I remember all the time my sis provoked you that way. Like that time where she gave you chocolates labeled 1, 2, and 4 during Valentine's Day, and you were pissed about the lack of a 3. Or that time you left an unopened beer bottle on the table and she sneakily opened it and took a sip. She didn't tell you she did it, and you were confused all day long. She always bragged she knew me like the back of her hand. If the letter was supposed to piss me off like that, I guess she had all the rights to brag. Maybe she was being sincere, though. She did express to me that she was sorry on more than one occasion. She did, huh? You told me she died from, localized nanomachine rejection, right? In her heart, yeah. Instead of the massive rejection that always makes the news, her case was more focused. They usually amputate or replace the part and call it a day. But organs are different. The condition made her susceptible to transplant rejections. Not to mention artificial hearts and genetic treatments were out of the question. Yep. Thing is, apparently she suffered that since she was 18, but kept it a secret from everyone. Why? Hell if I know. I was angry to learn that she hid it. Why didn't she tell me? Was it to avoid worrying me? Was she ashamed? What was it? Wait, how did she live so normally then? She had to use a serum, shots near her heart every 3 days. Apparently the serum burns like hell. The shot even left her a nasty mark where she had to apply them.
So the thing near her left breast wasn't a birthmark?
And the rejection was what ended up killing her? The nanomachine rejection was what ended up killing her, but they couldn't find out what made her so vulnerable. Doctors said she might have missed a shot, or the shots made her other defenses grow weaker. The condition could have just gone nuts out of nowhere, or maybe it was blood pressure. Maybe it was a regular heart attack and the rejection acted afterwards. They don't know. She kept it a secret from everyone, so nobody knows. Maybe if she had told me about it, I could have helped her. Maybe she'd still be alive. Maybe she wouldn't have faced it alone instead of just dying in her sleep. Thinking about what ifs won't bring her back. I spent so much time hammering myself with what ifs after you told me she died. What if I waited to cool down a bit back then? What if I just swallowed my fear at that very moment? What if I had apologized earlier? What if I had given a chance to the Research Institute thing back then? And the amount just increased threefold after I lashed out at you the other day. But today, I realized something. Having such regrets with the dead is a hollow effort. You're alive. You're here. I can make amends with you. But I can't make amends with the dead. I can't apologize to her like I can apologize to you right now.
Chill.
Lenore, she's resting now. She's just resting after having that heart condition all these years. She didn't have to face it alone, though. If she only... So, let's celebrate her life and achievements. If we're to mourn, let's mourn her together. If we're to honor her, we'll do it together.
Together?
Lenore was a fun-loving person. The best we can do right now is try to lighten up, even if it's only for a moment. I need to ask, though. Did she really start to complain about chest pain shortly after I left?
No.
She didn't get visibly worse after you left or anything. Everything was actually too sudden.
She did complain about chest pains from time to time, but that actually goes way back before you left. Back then, I thought it was just acid reflux or something.
I was convinced that Joe treating Lenore wrong weakened her, and thus made her more susceptible for dying. Yeah.
God, I even blamed her death on you. I was just too angry back then, and part of me just wanted to put the blame on someone or something. And you didn't deserve that. Sorry.
Hey, I'm sorry too, you know? We both had things to apologize for. Don't think too much about it. I should have been more mature and not shouted at you either, so... Let's just call all that water under the bridge, shall we?
Are you sure?
Of course I am.
So, how did you find me, exactly? Well, have you heard a message board called Danger You?
I have, yeah.
Well, truth is that I visit it from time to time. And the other day, I read a thread that discussed the bar. And the description of the bartender sounded just like you.
Are you mad? No, not mad. More like dumbfounded.
Hey, Jill. Can you tell me what the problem was back then?
She read about how flat Jill is. That's hilarious.
What sparked that fight? Weren't you happy with my sister?
Well, back then, I didn't know what to do with myself after I graduated college. I went in and pretty much hated my last couple of years there. It's not far-fetched to think that I only tolerated being there because your sister was with me. Had she stopped supporting my studies, I would have quit right there and then. And then after graduating, I got a very good job offer that she accepted on my behalf in no time. She kept saying it was the best for me and my future, but I was livid. Why did she have to do that? I hated it. I didn't even know if I wanted to go there, but she still insisted so much. Just like Gargara. I don't know who that is, DJ. Like she was forcing that burden on me. And then Mai became our future, and she started talking about marriage.
You're going to get married?
I don't think we ever took it seriously. It was just something she kept mentioning. Not like we didn't think about that down the line, but she mostly teased me with it. But the thought suddenly scared the shit out of me. I loved her, but I don't think I was ready for such a commitment, especially considering what she did. I don't know what I wanted to do, but I wasn't going to let her decide such a big thing for me. I mean, she could be really pushy from time to time. Like I said, I pretty much passed college thanks to being with her, and that was partly because she was so pushy. Even if she had the best intentions, she could be abrasive from time to time. And it rained down on me at that moment. She took it upon herself to make that choice for me. What would have stopped her once we got married? What if she suddenly decided to craft my life to her needs after marriage? I knew her. She would do it thinking it was the best for me. But what about my freedom? My say on the matter?
So that's where you stopped loving Lenore?
No! No. I never stopped loving her. Which is why it hurt so much. But you have to understand. I didn't want to wake up 40 years old and working a job I hate. Jesus. Yeah. Just out of routine, getting used to it. I wanted to break from everything for a while and put my thoughts in order. Regroup myself, think carefully about what to do next.
I can understand. I sometimes felt that same, although I'm not even in college. So that's what led to you two fighting, huh?
You know, the word fight makes it sound like we exchanged blows or something. It's all silly when I think back to it. Tragically silly. Maybe I was the one that started the fight, getting all defensive about not wanting to take that offer. Perhaps if I didn't overreact to her arguments about wasting this huge opportunity, maybe she wouldn't have lashed out at me this bad. It could have been avoided if I had just kept a cool head and talked about that with her.
My sister said something like that. I told you she mentioned on more than one occasion how sorry she was about the whole thing, right? Should have listened to her at the end, but instead I kept pushing her. I should have kept a cool head instead of letting my jealousy take the best of me. It was her offer, not mine. Should have stopped projecting myself so much into her. Something like that.
Lenore.
We're quite the hotheads. You, me, my sis.
You were supposed to be the mature one, you know? Play your role correctly.
But why didn't you come back, Jill? Did you end up hating us that much? Did the breakup include us too?
No, it's just that...
Remember when your sister was giving a class and you broke a window? How you didn't want to see her for fear of being scolded? But my sister wouldn't have scolded you.
But I was afraid. Dead afraid. I couldn't bring myself to face your sister.
But I faced her back then, and I was, like, 7 at the time. Why couldn't you do it? It's not quite the same. And in perspective, no matter what reason I came up with, it'll never make sense. Everything sounds very stupid when I look back, you know? Not that it makes things easier. I won't ever get to speak to her ever again, and it feels bad because it's stupid. I swear, you and my sis were meant for one another. You both moved on after all that, but neither had the courage to go back and say you're sorry. Like I said, berating myself over these past mistakes won't bring her back. I miss her so much, though. We were together all the time, always talking about dumb stuff. I would call my parents useless, but she was the one I could always talk to. I feel her absence every day. Everything is just so quiet now. She was an amazing person. Yeah, she was an amazing person. Huh? Mourning is fine and all, but we should be celebrating her life. If she was here, she would tell us that there's no fun in sulking so long. She told you that all the time. The same way she told you to stop rubbing things in people's faces. Both figuratively and literally. Hey, I was 8 back then. So let's have a toast in her honor, shall we? A toast? Let me get you a drink. I'll need to get something non-alcoholic. A drink? Don't worry, trust me. Let's find something to toast Gabby with. Something sweet. Do we have a non-alcohol? This one. Perfect. Me. Let me see if there's any others. Technically, all of these work. Now that I think of it. They're all optional karma trine. Not Moonblast. You can't have a Moonblast. You can't have a Brantini. Or a Piano Woman. So it looks like you're getting something the first ones. Like the Sugar Rush, I think? Sugar Rush was... Yeah. Yeah, Sugar Rush. Sugar Rush was perfect. Sweet, girly, optional Karma Trine. Yeah, perfect. This works. One Powder Delta. Yeah, who cares? Let's get it. Grab this for a sec. Okay. Lenore, I know you're watching from the beyond right now, as I give a drink to your little sister. It's obvious to me now that we both meant to make amends at some point, but we never got around to it. I can't apologize to you anymore, but I can at the very least make you rest easier. So, know that I'll look out for Gabby in your absence. I'll make sure Gabby grows into a fine woman, just like you were. I'll always be there for her. I'll be sure the little brat doesn't face the same problem you and I had. Hey! Want to add anything? I'll always miss her. Don't say it to me. Say it to her. That's a bit... Come on, just this once. Why is Gabby still doing the epic pouting maneuver? Well, it's still her dead sister, you know. Give her, she's like 12, give her some slack. I'll always miss you, sis. Sis. Idiot. Why did you keep that secret for so long? Idiot. I always told you everything. Wasn't I enough? You idiotic idiot. Ugh. Hey, Jill, promise me you won't be like that knucklehead, that you won't keep stuff like that from to yourself. Only if you promise the same to me. And promise me we won't fight. I can't do that. Huh? You and I are both too thick-headed. Sooner or later, we'll clash on some opinion.
But what I can promise is that I won't run away like last time. We'll both cool off and talk it over like the adults we are.
I'm not an adult.
Let's face it, you've been more mature than I have.
Hey, did you mean what you said? That you'll look after me?
I'll always be there for you, Gabby. I mean, I'm not Lenore, but I wouldn't dare leave my little sister alone.
Chill. Hey, wasn't it the toast?
Right, for Lenore, faithful sister and girlfriend. Cheers.
Cheers. So, about this drink, can I drink it?
Do you like it? Take a sip.
It's not bad.
Why not drink it then? You're with an adult. We might as well break the alcohol taboo here and now.
Right.
I didn't put any alcohol in it. What do you mean? Now that I think back to it, didn't your sister give you beer once as a prank?
That. It was April Fool's. I should have known better when she offered me apple soda. I put bubblegum on the soles of all her shoes in retaliation. She walked funny, and my jaw hurt for the rest of the day.
Yeah, but did you know you got my drink that time?
Huh?
She gave me a beer, and it turned out to be apple soda.
Oh. Did you get back at her?
Well, it did. I did hide all the dildos in the house that night, only to find out she knew how to use a cucumber. And as a follow-up, she used that same cucumber in a salad 3 days later. She said, so, do you like eating me for lunch?
Damn, okay. Jill? I'll tell you when you're older.
Or never at all.
Hey, Gabby, do your parents know you're here? They think I'm at Clary's, actually.
Who?
Oh, she's my best friend at school.
And this Clary knows you're using her as an excuse, right?
Of course. How would she cover for me otherwise?
True. Will you go to her house afterwards?
To be honest, I didn't think that far. Maybe I will. I do live in another district, but Clary doesn't live close by, so...
Well, it can't be helped. I live nearby and the streets aren't exactly safe at night, so why not stay with me tonight?
Are you sure?
I don't live in a mansion, but I'd say it's comfy enough, at least to spend the night.
Sure, I'd love to stay with you.
Great.
Hey, does your dad still do that bakery? His bread was really good. Yep, he opened a second branch last year.
So he's looking to expand?
I think he got into a partnership with a friend in Motor District. That guy saw an opportunity after realizing Motor District has almost no bakeries. I still remember when your sister introduced me to him. He started shouting, "I knew it! I fucking knew you were a lesbian! Mark one for daddy!" I think he had this bet with an acquaintance of his ever since my sis was 12 years old or so. Dad said Sis was into girls. The acquaintance didn't believe him. He bet a beer on whether he was right or not. That beer bottle is still in the fridge. It's even labeled Sweet Victory.
Your mom and Lenora never made up, did they?
I guess that one wasn't as simple as the said one too many things argument. Mom was always obsessed with high society and her circle of friends. A lesbian daughter was a no-no. I'm still on my sis's side for that one, though. Mom didn't reject her because she herself was homophobic, she did it because her friends were. To Mom, the opinion of her circle of friends was worth more than her own daughter.
How did she react to her death?
Dunno. Mom and Dad broke up 2 years ago.
They did?
They never got married, so there was no proper divorce. I haven't seen her since, August, I think?
Did you two fight?
No, she just hasn't shown up.
You must have felt alone, huh? I've been there.
A bit, but I'm not alone anymore, thanks to you.
Huh? I thought there was gonna be a party here. Alma, over here.
Party?
A small New Year celebration. I want to stay for a bit? Or stay for it?
I don't want a kid to burden...
Don't worry, you won't. You'll only get cola for the night, though, no alcohol. It'll give us time to catch up even more. I can introduce you to some friends. Are you in?
If you don't mind me.
Great. Hey, Alma, come here. There's someone I want to introduce you to.
That's sweet. So down to earth and well written. It is. It's a very well written game.
God bless Fernando. For real, for real.
Me right there! Thank you, the player! Oh my gosh.
Had to go AFK and missed the end. I don't think I got a specific end. I mean, Alma came in. So, I mean, it really wasn't indicative to an ending. I think if I don't know what endings are, like what possible endings we have. I know there's a bad one for getting evicted, but we paid our rent, so we're fine. Did you have fun? There are six! The Valhalla bar will return in Avengers. Did you have fun? Yes. Yep, I also got to meet a cat boomer. Why did your boss hug you though? I think I have to watch this go. She's, that kind of person. Now let's sleep. You were dozing off back there.
Right. Good night, Jill.
You managed to pay your monthly rent. You win. That's the only ending I knew. We'll play some more tomorrow. Good night.
Thank you.
Hogger. We're gamers. We did it. Now we're gonna have to find out what game we're gonna do next. We could do a short one. Because we do still need to play Little Nightmares too. It's true. Oh, Saturday, February 25th. I can't believe you actually made me do that sleepover thing. You didn't have to accept, you know. Shut up. I'm having a good time. See? Even Gabby's having fun. Relax a bit. Yeah, whatever. You know, Alma, you remind me a bit of my sis. I do? How? You always manage to get a reaction from Jill. Life of Pi is a I don't believe you, DJ. Sis always said that Jill acknowledging your presence is the best way to know she likes you. You're talking too much, Gabby. Aww. It's different with you, though. With my sis, Jill is more frustrated. Like the one time where she bought her a shirt that... You're talking too much, little girl. A shirt that what? They had a pic of a cucumber on it. Oh. Cucumber. Ow! Just what are you doing with my hair? Sorry, it got stuck in one of my fingers. If Gabby was not around, Alma would have... Sure. Seriously. So, I'm a bit like Lenore, then. For sure. No, you just remind me of her a bit. Moreover, my sister wasn't as... ass. What this girl is trying to say is that that with your tits and ass, you could build a Lenore and a half out of the mess. That just means there's enough to share with both of you. Share? You're talking too much, Alma. Friday. January 15th. So, yeah, the guy had a fantasy about a woman castrating him. I tried for an hour to convince him it's a bad idea, and I finally got to him. We finally moved to the bedroom, and it turns out the guy has a weird implant where his testicles should be. It's basically a removable ball sack. I suppose the guy really liked the fantasy and made sure he could live it out properly. I once saw a guy at the hospital in the emergency room after having been castrated to fulfill a fantasy. I wonder if it's the same guy. I have enough problems with just one, you know? Just one what? With just listening to one of your anecdotes. You told me that the Neo Tijuana thing, and now this? Don't you have a more subdued story? Come on, Joe. You're an adult. You can take that much. Shut up. Well, last time I spoke with my mom, I asked her the story of her daughter. Turns out her name was Anna. Oh. Huh. And now you pretend it's a surprise? Tijuana is a place in northern Mexico. Yes, I do know that one. How do I know that? Pen and paper took place there. Oh, well, hey. You can learn things from anywhere. Quiet, you. She fought against nanomachine rejection for most of her life. She even lost a girlfriend she made in the hospital to that same sickness. Apparently, sometime after she got out of treatment, a truck hit her and killed her. But even then, she was amazing. She was? Huh? Yeah, she kept up her studies while still in the hospital. She was a self-taught honor student. Not only that, but she also ranked among the top 5 candidates in at least 3 colleges' admission exams. She also played the piano and guitar. Well, being confined to a room does that, I guess. I mean, fully able-bodied people can barely do half of that. But she practically accomplished all that by herself. And she's also beat nanomachine rejection, a disease that only 2% of humans suffer and even less survive. Took a trucking truck to take her down. She was great. And to think I'm sort of like her. Like her sister. Silly Becky. A did you say something?
I did not.
Weird. I swear I heard somebody call me Silly Becky.
Come again? Good evening. Hi, Toka. Hi. We're finishing up Valhalla. Glad to see you.
It's not uncommon for me to hear stuff from far away and think I've heard it nearby, but I'm new here. Hi. Hi, Toka.
I'm dying.
You're the only one nearby that knows my real name, so it was weird.
Oh, well, as I was saying, the ballsack guy. Oh, wait, no.
Oh, as I was saying, the ballsack guy.
Right, okay. Misjudged who was talking there. I guess this is where we part ways, huh? Sadly, I'm bound to this city. I can only falsify my identity effectively around here. I really want to thank you, Chief, for the second chance you gave me. If we ever cross paths again, we're leaving for like a week and a half or something. Don't be so dramatic. And you're taking care of my apartment. We will cross paths because I live there. That time you spend setting up a useless farewell could be used asking me things about the place. Like where the switches and valves are. But I already know. They're in that control panel you made.
Talking about that control panel, I'm proud of it.
Speaking of obsessive likes, Jill, stop calling Armitage. She'll take care of your four ball just fine. I'm not worried about him. I'm worried about me. I've never been away from four this long. I don't know what I'll do.
You'll do just fine. You did pretty well for that for at least 25 years before finding him.
Yeah, but we're leaving. Oh, yeah, before I forget. I left you a box of condoms on the first drawer in the desk, Gil.
You what?
Hey, if he wants to bring his new girlfriend or whatever here, I want him to be ready. Oh, but just one condition. If you're gonna fuck like rabbits, stay away from my room. I have too many pics of my Imoto there, and I don't want their eyes soiled.
Imohu?
Little sister.
Then just say little sister.
Oh yeah, Gil does have a someone, yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
First off, Panama. You can now save heart data. Heart data from the title screen or bar will let you start over from day one while keeping your items and money!
Yes! Save! Yeah, baby!
We did it, guys. We played the game. Which means we have to come up with a new game to play. We do have a list of games that we can play. So, we should get on that.
Oh, look, they changed the title. Oh, that's so cute.
Gabby's there with us. That's cute. He has the charm of a rogue with a secret past, so he's like Sasuke in the first season of Naruto, only working in a cocktail bar instead of a ninja village. Except Arkham. We do need to do Tomb Raider, I know. Hold on. Let me move over to Chill and I'll bring up the list. Hold on. Where am I looking? Oh, so the. I know! We're not doing Life of Pi! DJ, love you to death. I don't think we're ever gonna do Life of Pi, though. Because it's not on the list. I don't own it. We have things that I own, and that's it. Let's see. Stream list. Here. Okay, let me go over and display it. Why did I purchase? Did you purchase it for me? Did you? Oh my god, I'm a fake fan. Here. This is the list. We can cross off Valhalla. That's exciting. That's progress. Which means we have to put it down here. Okay, hold on. Let me get this taken care of. Perfect. Didn't I do that?
Let me see. Games, library. It would be... Girl, a mysterious gentleman from overseas leaves you a gift and you don't notice? What do you mean? I've received a lot of gifts, okay? Oh, do you mean Lies of P? I thought you... Is this what you meant? I thought you were talking about that stupid movie about the tiger. Life of Pi. This I do remember. Life, lies. The problem with saying life instead of lies is that Life of Pi is a real thing. Life of Pi. See? I thought you were talking about this. Dude, I'm like, I have no interest in being on a boat with a tiger. He just didn't want to tell you lies. Sure. All right, whatever. Anyway. I have that book. You have it, don't you? That's nice. That's cool. I do not have the book, though. So Tomb Raider, we do need to do Tomb Raider, I know. But we could do something short first. Something that's easy to get out of the way. And I feel like Tomb Raider's gonna take fucking ever. You will leave lie. My attention span? I got a short attention span. You know what's short? We could do Frog Detective. I don't know if I have all three of them. I might. But I also might not. Hatovo Boyfriend probably would be short. But it's also a lot of reading. Little Nightmares is short. That's the only one I know for sure is short. I don't know how long... I think Strange Horticulture might be a long one. Like, I don't really know how long a lot of these are. I just know that Frog Detective is short. Little Nightmares is probably also short. If it's anything like the last game, so. Yeah. I don't know. Ouch. My freaking ouchie. My knee. Little Nightmares is around 8 hours? You're lying to me. Little Nightmares 2. Well, they won't tell me how long the playtime is. The first one was like 6. Well, ain't no way. Start page. Shush. Do not play anything. Why do we not have an average play length? Well, we tried. We tried. I don't know then. We could do Frog Detective is short. Because that actually gives you the playtime. It's like 15 minutes. It's like 15 minutes to play a frog game. But like, as opposed to Valhalla. Valhalla is a long game. Yakuza is a long game. Tomb Raider is probably going to take for fucking ever, I imagine. Spider-Man was a long game. That's long games. You know what was an unbearably long game? One Punch Man, A Hero Nobody Knows. That game was insufferable. I was miserable when we were playing that game. Unless it can be a short game if you give up early. I would. I would. I'm scared of it. Let's see. We can't fit all of them, but The Witcher 3 is a long one, so we won't start that one next. The Bridge Curse might be a short one. And it's scary. We've been too wholesome around here. We need to be scared. We gotta be scared. Is a game you can finish in like 3 to 4 hours? Oh, okay. I don't remember how long Shrek 2 is. I played it a lot when I was young. I loved it. Bumble with a 15 stream streak. Hi, welcome in. Thank you so much for the 15 stream streak. You're probably still streaming yourself, so no stress. But yeah, thank you. Disco Elysium is hard as fuck, so we probably won't do that one either. Strange Horticulture is a very cozy game, though. You should not hurry through it. Yeah, that's fair. I don't know how long How to Date a Magical Girl is. And I hear it's really scary. Not like really scary, but I hear it has horror elements in it, which is disturbing. It's like when you read Doki Doki Literature Club on the store page and you see that it has psychological horror in the tags and you're like, what the fuck? I don't know. We'll have to think about it. At Dead of Night was very scary. I did play a little bit of it. I never got very far in it. I played it with my brothers, Ugensu. And I would get startled and I would hide in a room for like 5 minutes because I just needed to like calm down and catch my breath. It was a very tense game. It's very good. I do like it from what I did see. Dead of Night was a good game. Demon Slayer is probably gonna take forever. I just also got those confusing combos, so unlikely that we will enjoy it. Well, I probably won't enjoy it. I also haven't finished Demon Slayer, so we'll hold off on that one. The Letter is a scary one. Quest is made by my brother's friend, and I got it for free. And I never finished it. I wouldn't mind restarting for that one. It was fun what I did enjoy. My brother and I played it side by side. And we actually ended up having completely different adventures. Like, I don't know, man. He ended up finding like a rat king or something. And I was just in a wizard tower. I don't know. I don't know, man. Lots of interesting stuff. Yeah. We did it. We played the game. I've had a blast with you guys. I'm gonna be real. I'm probably gonna play Cowboys with my friend tonight. So, no more word from me. Don't know when our next stream is going to be either. Probably on Tuesday. If I do, I might. If I can convince myself to play like Genshin or something that's a little less attentive over the week, the work week that I have. And then we might do another stream. But like, if I don't set the date ahead of time, I have a really hard time committing to stuff. Like, if I don't have anyone to hold me accountable for my actions, I'll be like, I don't want to do it anymore. Which is true in a lot of aspects, not just in streaming. I don't know. I just a lot of work. It's a lot of work. But I don't know. I think we're done. I think we'll probably call it. Yeah. Not be right back. This. Let me see if I can find someone who is live. There's probably someone who's live. Bumble is still live, playing the new content, the new DBD content. Lara Croft is in there, which is very funny because we will be playing Tomb Raider eventually. We'll probably play we'll play something short probably, a shorter game. Not necessarily a short game, but a shorter game. And then we'll probably jump into Tomb Raider, since DJ has been waiting. Not DJ. Mercury's been waiting on that for a little bit. So, we're going to raid Bumble. Bumble's playing Dead by Daylight. Lara Croft is in there. There's a Lara Croft in his lobby right now. So make sure that you guys stick around and show Bumble the same love and support that you've been showing me. I appreciate you guys sticking with me through the story of Valhalla. He's got crunch bars up. You guys are going to need to see this. So I will see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.